What's up everybody, this is Lost Frequencies and we are back in a in-studio session with me. So, like you maybe saw on my social media or maybe somewhere else, I made a remix for Estelle and Kanye West's American Boy. I was really stoked to get this request from the original label. They asked me to make a remix for this track, which is a really an amazing track. Let's listen to it right now. First, the original version.
This is number one champion sound. Yeah, Estelle, we about to get down. Who the hottest in the world right now? Just touched down in London town.
Take me on a trip, I'd like to go someday. Take me to New York, I'd love to see LA.
So there you go, the original version is a really cool track. And when I got the stems, I was really excited. I really didn't know where I was going, but then I think it turned out to be one of my best remixes I've done for someone. I made a lot of remixes, like you guys maybe know. I make a lot of remixes of my own tracks, a lot of remixes for other people. And this remix now for Estelle and Kanye West, written by John Legend, I think, American Boy. I think it sounds dope. So now let's listen to my version real quick.
Take me on a trip, I'd like to go someday. Take me to New York, I'd love to see LA. I really want to come pick you with you. You'll be my American boy.
Yeah, Estelle, we're about to get down. Yeah, Estelle, we're about to get down.
Okay, so as you can see, it's a completely takeover of the track, but still you really can feel the original vibe, but it has a lot of electronic touches to it. So let's dive immediately into it. This is a more recent project, so for me, it also really feels more complete production-wise and sound design-wise and mixing-wise than other projects that I might have shown you before. So let's check it immediately. I kept the original vocal from the guys, from Kanye West, from Estelle, and that's what I kept. I kept the hi-hats they gave me because yeah, they sound nice and groovy, and the guitar. All the rest I threw away because I really wanted to take it from a fresh start, but I want to keep the harmonics from the guitar because it's really cool. It sounds really... They sound really cool, the guitars, and yeah, so that's the only thing I kept from the melodic-wise from the original track. So I'm gonna close this. Let's start from the beginning. This is the extended version. I immediately started to work on an extended editor for this track. Sometimes I start the radio edit because I know how to start, but sometimes I don't know really where I'm trying to go, so I'm first looking for the right sounds and the right samples and the right grooves, and then I evolve and into the track and make what's it now. So yeah, let's start from the beginning. I made a kick on kick 2. I think it sounds really good. So I took a preset, I changed a little bit, I think the key of the kick to put it in key. The full kick is here. I think it sounds really cool. I'm gonna put my two ears plugged so I'm gonna hear everything better. I think this kick sounds really good. Also, it blends perfectly with the track, with all the rest of the instruments. It goes really low, but really deep, but you can really hear it. And then in the intro, I just took the low ends off. I took a lot of mids away I don't know why it sounded better on the kick. So this is the kick without the low ends. And then, just for the extended edit. I used a synthesizer, I think it's this one, not audio file. I used a synthesizer to make a really cool white noise effect with the 5-filter, the FF Twin 2. Of the FF1, I use like a FX effect, white noise, noise, something like this, and here somewhere. Like I drew a whole note, and then I bounced it and I cut it, and in the end with this synthesizer I used to do something like this, and then at the end I had something like this. It might sound random, but then it with the kick you can really feel it grooves a little bit. It gives a really cool atmosphere vibe to the intro. And then I used some of the sounds to make it like a hi-hat somehow. I used it here, it sounds really cool. So it was just a cool way to try stuff. So that's the beginning with the claps that I have here. They are here, my bad. I just took some loops. They sound good. The clap sounds cool. And I put a small acid FX just to have some atmosphere in the intro of the track. Alone, it sounds like this. Reverb, EQ. Delay, reverb again, compression, EQ again, and then it sounds like this. And there you have it, the hi-hats that I kept from the original track. And this is the beginning of the track. Really easy. Then this comes in. This is the original sound. And now the bass and the sub. Here also a sweep that I created with the synthesizer. So there you go. So what happens here? There is in the claps I have like a clap delay, I like to call it. So what it does, it's just a delay, and it just delays once. So the feedback is really small. The mix is almost 50%, and it delays just once to give it some groove. So. And the bass. This is gonna be the bass for the whole track. It's this synth from Arturia, I really like it. The CS80, open please, don't bug. I really like this synthesizer. It has a lot of cool sounds. I use it a lot in my latest tracks. You're gonna see it appear again in other sounds in this project. Like you can see, there you go. This is the original sound. But then I took away the high ends. Just to keep the sub, I use the limiter to make it sound a little bit fatter, and then the kickstart, you know, sidechain from Nicky Romero, it's pretty handful with the kick. It sounds really good, and then again a small reverse. If you watched my other tutorial, you know how I do this a lot. So there you go. So this is the beginning of the track. Until here, this is the first part. So I have my keyboard that I really like. It's again the CS80 that I told you about. This is the original sound. And the filter opens. So really easy, it just goes up. I have one more plug here. It's also the CS80 from Arturia, I told you. Sounds really cool. It goes up. It opens. FX. Some distortion. So yeah, I like to make my sound move. I use the I try a lot of new plugins. This one is Devastor. It's a distortion plugin, more old school-ish. So I have to automate the output and the FX. If I put it more wet, it's gonna go really louder. So I have to handle the output together. But so that's why there are so much automations. When it goes up, so this sounds good. I have the atmosphere; it just stays there, and then everything's there. I cut the vocal to make it sounds like groove, like this. So there you go, first part, and then it goes up. Bass. The bass sounds really cool. It's from Output. I'm gonna open for you. You put it in Contact 5 from Native Instrument, and you put it there. Substance from Output. It's really cool. This preset Alias Bob, I use it sometimes to have this more groovy bass line, more almost like 808. But it sounds really cool. And then I have my snare roll right here, which sounds also nice. So alone. So you hear the filter is coming up, but what I did is I put one snare and then I took three others and I put here the gain less louder. If you can see it here, you don't see it. Then that means I bounced it. But usually I take a snare and then I put the volume here less louder and it gives you this more human touch to the snare. Goes up. I have here a clap that goes, gonna do some FX. Also, this one is the same as the deep. It's only the clap with full reverb 100% and a kickstart on it, just to give this. So it's a layering for this one actually. Build up with the kicks. So yeah, a little bit EQing, and the kick goes up. Yeah, Estelle, we're about to get down. And there you go. There you have the main theme of the whole track. It's gonna come over and over and over. It's probably gonna be the CS80. There you go. That's the main sound of the track. Without all the effects, it's probably almost the same. Oh, no, not really. Dun, 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 dun. So if I put the channel EQ on it, the kickstart sidechain, and all the rest, it really opens up. So I'm gonna show you one by one the channel EQ. Just where I take all the bass away. You hear it somewhere around the end, like a doo-doo-doo. It's slow, so I just cut it. Then I put some reverb. Sounds cool. I distort it a little bit. Without. with kickstart. Before I used the kickstart 100%, but now I try to use it less to give more space to everything, to keep everything breathing, and then some EQ again. This is just later on, I think, when I used the distort, it added some low end, so I cut it again. And there you go, this is the main synth. I use the layering, which is complete, almost the same, but I add a delay so I can layer the sounds in the back. So it's again 100% wet, so it doesn't bother the other one. Without the delay one. It actually adds a lot in between all the parts. This is the main synth, a keyboard. Another keyboard. This is my atmosphere's flute. It adds some nice excitement on the top. One more keyboard is a little bit more groovy. Synthplant, you know, love this synthesizer. Really organic sound. My bass, which is the same as the intro. And all the rest, you know, everything is there. With the acid. So that's basically it for almost the whole track, basically. Just arrangement with the vocals. There you go, it just goes on and on. Since I changed a little bit the chords, I couldn't use all the guitar chords, so I only used three. The fourth one, I think I changed it. So I only kept three chords of the guitar and I had some delay. Without it, it's like this. And so I had some delay, so it goes like. Kanye West, come in. Get down. So Kanye West is coming in. You have the lead vocal. And you have the vocal I used with some delay and distortion to create like this whole environment vibe. The snare roll. Tell him I'm wild. So he sings. I had to cut a little bit Kanye West part, sorry, because it was really long. Now he's rapping for 1 whole minute on the whole instrumental. So I tried to change a little bit the instrumental sometimes to keep everything entertaining. So here, for example. Reluctantly, 'cause most of this press don't fuck with me. Estelle once said, tell me cool down, down. Don't act a fool now. Always act a fool. So yeah, I use this little bass following the vibe of Kanye West. To keep everything like changing and adding. Otherwise it was really just the same. I also have a small kick reverse. Which is like the kick in reverse, it basically says. And it adds on the whole groove of the bass. So it's like There you go, and then again. This goes one octave lower to change a little bit. I took the delay part away here because it wasn't really fitting. And then again. Here the last part, the guitar has the bass line that goes up, which is funky, and then some toms with some delay. So without all the effects, it sounds like this. And with all the effects. Build up. Last part with the vocal of Estelle. So yeah, this was a really quick insight of the remix I made for Kanye West and Estelle Kanye West, American Boy. Hope you guys liked it. I loved making this remix, and I hope you're gonna listen to it. You can share it with your friends. And be creative again. Try new stuff. This is also was kind of a lot of new sounds for me, but I'm loving it. I had a great time making this remix. Again, I hope you guys gonna enjoy it. If you have some comments, put it in the comment section. I'm gonna try to answer it. And I'm gonna try to make also other videos like this one. Enjoy, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and see you next time.